What it do, guys? Manjame here, and today we're going to be checking out Legendary Doctor Strange and the Shadows of Nightmare. See, this is, as of recording, the newest box to come out, and hopefully right around the time that I upload it. I do not want to be sitting on this footage for a long time, primarily because this stuff adds up. I have a lot of time. Taking a look at the front of the box, we have Doctor Strange himself. We have a dude, something of a nightmare in the shadow, I assume. On the side, we see both characters, once again. And the other side, same exact thing. And then on the back, to sleep, perchance to dream, this is the hunting ground for nightmare, and all those who shut their eyes risk being trapped for eternity in his torturous embrace. Recruit multiple masters of the mystic arts from this talented cauldron of heroes, led by the Sorcerer Supreme, Doctor Strange. Only their combined strength can stand against the denizens of darkness like Nightmare and Dormammu in this terrifying expansion to Legendary and Marvel deck building game. The Doctor Strange expansion includes the following: 100 playable cards, 5 heroes, 2 new masterminds and villain groups, and a rule sheet. Now they've already themselves spoiled the big baddies. Do they usually do that? I don't know. Another green. Let's see. In this one, we have Avengers and Marvel Knights. Demonic Bargain. Some villains like Satana Hellstrom say things like fight, choose a player to make a demonic bargain with Satana Hellstrom to rescue 3 bystanders. That player discards the top card of their deck to see if they are corrupted by power. If that discarded card costs 1 or more, that player is too powerful and arrogant to resist temptation and gains a wound to the villain's delight. If that discarded card costs 0, then that player has been humbled enough to resist corruption. The bargain is that you either get the bad thing or you don't. Astral Plane. While a villain is in the astral plane, it has no physical form and can only be fought with stars, not attack. To fight a 5 attack villain, you must spend 5 stars. When you fight a villain in the astral plane, put it in your victory pile and do its fight effect as normal. When a villain enters the astral plane, any villain already there escapes. This causes the same effects as if they had escaped the city. Same deal for the mastermind when they enter the astral plane. If he escapes the astral plane, do all the normal effects for them. For a villain escaping the city, and then I guess he goes back. Artifacts do come back, and now we have ritual artifacts. And they just say things like ritual artifact. If you drew a card, you may discard this artifact to do +3 attack. If you have fulfilled the listed ritual condition this turn, you can discard the ritual artifact to get the listed effect. You don't have to use the ritual effect even if you fulfill the condition. You might want to save it for a different turn or not. That's cool. This one came with 2 little mini decks. This one has a scheme, so I'm going to think this is like the bad guys and schemes. This is probably going to hold the heroes. So this must have the rest of the Ancient Ones cards. And if it doesn't, I'll be very upset. The Ancient One is rare, the Orb of Agamotto. 8 cost, ritual artifact. If you fought a villain or mastermind, you may set aside the Orb of Agamotto to reveal the top 4 cards of your deck. KO up to one of them, put 2 of them in your hand, put the rest back on the top of any order. Then discard the Orb of Agamotto. War of the Mind, that would be his uncommon. Teachings of Kamar Taj, that's a common. And Astral Confrontation, which is, funny thing, the only hero in the game that has a astral plane effect, which isn't the biggest deal because it's the set that this first came out in, but going down the line, who knows if we're gonna get many more because this is the ancient one we're talking about, so pretty special case. Next up, we have the Vishanti, the Book of the Vishanti, 7 cost, ritual artifact. If any player gained a wound, you may set aside the Book of Vishanti to KO up to one wound from any player's discard pile. Then draw 3 cards. Then discard the Book of Vishanti. You may use this during any player's turn. That seems super powerful. There is Agamotto themselves. That's pretty rad, and that's one of the characters seen here. Next one is Hoggoth, who seems to be the other character, so I'm gonna guess the next one is gonna be. And the last one is Ashtur, right there. Pretty cool. Dr. Voodoo, Possessed by Brother's Spirit. 7 costs, 0 stars, 4 plus attack. The first time that one of your heroes or a hero from your deck or discard pile is KO'd this turn, you get plus 4 stars or plus 4 attack. Either way, pretty strong. Staff of Legba, Ritual Artifact. So I'm going to guess every character is going to have at least one. Or multiples. Medallion of Many Lows. Or Lows. Commune with the Spirit World. Pretty neat. And as per pretty much every one of these expansions, except maybe the one with Howard the Duck, the heroes are going to have synergy with each other. So you're going to have the best synergy when you have a team full of the 5. The Purple Gem, Clea. 7 cost, Ritual Artifact, Marvel Knight. If any cards were revealed, looked at, or discarded from any deck, you may discard the Purple Gem to get plus 6 attack. Just drawing or playing a card from the deck does not count. Bind the Dark Dimension. Demonic Descent. Prepare Dark Magic. The man himself, the Eye of Agamotto. Doctor Strange, 8 cost, Ritual Artifact. If you played another artifact or 3 other cards of the same hero class, you may discard the Eye of Agamotto to get plus 7 attack. Book of Cagliostro. Another Ritual Artifact. Keeper of the Sanctum. And Wand of Watum, which I really like the way it looks. And I like this better than the Illuminati one that we got back in, gosh, what was that? Was that Secret Wars? Yeah, that was probably Secret Wars Volume 1. So, villain, Fear Lords, the Lurking Unknown. Dayspire. Nox. Dream Stalker. It's a Pegasus. And we have the Lords of the Netherworld, Umar. Satanish. Satana Hellstrom. Baron Mordor. There you go. Mindless Ones. Dormammu, Mastermind. 11 attack, always leads the Lords of the Netherworld. Master Strike, each player makes a demonic bargain with Dormammu to discard down to 4 cards. So if they lose the bargain, they have to do that. On the other side, the Epic version, 13 attack instead. Each player reveals the top card of their deck and discard it. If it costs 0, then each player makes a demonic bargain to Dormammu to discard down to 3 cards. Much more difficult. Torments of the Dark Dimension. Each player makes a demonic bargain with Dormammu to gain a 0-cost hero from the KO pile. Demonic Hellfire. Each other player makes a demonic bargain with Dormammu to KO a non-gray hero from their discard pile. Flames of Regency. Each other player makes a demonic bargain with Dormammu to discard a card with an attack icon. Barter for Souls. Choose a player to make a demonic bargain with Dormammu to gain a hero from the HQ that costs 6 or less. Then we have Nightmare. 6 attack. When you fight Nightmare in the Astral Plane, instead of revealing a tactic, KO one of your heroes and Nightmare moves to the Mastermind space. Always leads, Fear Lords. Master Strike. Nightmare enters the Astral Plane. If he was already there, each player discards a random card. Escape. Each player KOs one of their non-gray heroes. Nightmare moves to the Mastermind space. In the Epic version, he has 8 attack. Master Strike. He enters the Astral Plane. If he's already there, then each player discards 2 cards randomly. Escape. Each player KOs one of their non-gray heroes. Nightmare moves to the Mastermind space. So them escaping isn't even a way to get rid of him. Deadly Waking Nightmares. Each other player KOs one of their non-gray heroes. Each player who KO'd a hero this way draws a card. Nightmare enters the Astral Plane. Night Terrors. Each other player reveals a red hero or gains a wound. Nightmare enters the Astral Plane. Dream Weaver. For each of your blue heroes, rescue a bystander. Nightmare enters the Astral Plane. Don't Fall Asleep. Each other player discards two cards with star icons. Nightmare enters the astral plane. Duels of Science and Magic. Setup, two players, nine twists. One or four players, 10 twists. Three or five players, 11 twists. Twist 1, 3, and 5, Duel of Science. Each player reveals a tech or blue hero or discards down to 4 cards. If at least half the players round up failed to reveal, put this twist next to the mastermind as a duel 1. Twist 2, 4, and 6, Duel of Magic. Same effect, but with yellow or red. Twist 7 to 11, Duel of Science and Magic. Same effect, but each player must reveal at least 3 of these colors, yellow, red, tech, or blue. No green at all. Evil wins when the mastermind has won 5 duels. I feel like that's a Dormammu. I'm not quite sure about Nightmare Man. Cursed Pages of the Darkhold Tomb. 11 twists representing Cursed Pages of the Darkhold Tomb add an extra villain group. Special rules. Cursed Pages are ritual artifacts with, if you fought a villain or mastermind, you may discard this to get plus 3 stars. Twist. Put this cursed page next to the mastermind plus a cursed page from any player's control or discard pile to the KO pile. For only this turn, the first time you fight a villain or mastermind, put one of the mastermind's cursed pages into your discard pile. Evil wins when the mastermind has 7 cursed pages at the end of any player's turn or the villain deck runs out. Not sure. I'm going to say maybe Nightmare. War for the Dream Dimension. 7 twists, add an extra villain group. Twist, reveal the top 2 cards of the villain deck. The villain you revealed with the highest printed attack enters the astral plane, but do not use their ambush abilities. If you revealed a second villain this way, that villain enters the city. Put the rest of the revealed cards back in any order. Evil wins when there are 3 villains per player in the escape pile or the villain deck runs out. Since it is for the Dream Dimension, I'm going to say Nightmare. And Claim Souls for Demons is going to be for Dormammu, but let's check it out. 8 twists. Twist 1 to 3. Each player makes a demonic bargain to rescue a bystander. If that bargain wounds that player, stack that bystander next to the scheme as a tormented soul instead. Twist 4 to 8. Each player makes a demonic bargain to gain a shield officer. If that bargain wounds that player, stacks the officer next to the scheme as a tormented soul instead. Evil wins when the number of tormented souls is 4 times the number of players. Ouch. So definitely going to be a Dormammu card. So Nightmare is going to get Cursed Pages of the Darkhold Tomb and War for the Dream Dimension. And the big baddie himself, Dormammu, is going to get Duels of Science and Magic and Claim Souls for Demons. Fits them pretty well, I think. What do you guys think of what I picked scheme-wise per mastermind? Which one of these heroes was your favorite? I kind of really like the Ancient One. Although second favorite is going to have to be Doctor Strange, who I am definitely going to be using very soon in other like MCU inspired ones. In fact, I think the next one, maybe not even the next one, but one of the next one is going to involve the Doctor Strange MCU movie leading up to the Multiverse of Madness. And in it, we're going to be using at least the titular character, Doctor Strange, the Ancient One, and Dormammu, as well as his villain group, at the very least. If it's going to be a single player, meaning only 3 heroes, we only have to fill up one more space. What do you guys think would fit well in that one space that's left for an MCU Doctor Strange 1 movie tie-in game? Well, guys, that's it for Legendary Doctor Strange and the Shadows of Nightmare. If you want to stay up to date on my videos and live streams on both YouTube and Twitch, check out the links in the description below. Like, comment, subscribe, and consider joining. That's all for now, guys. Majo Mei out.